Hi, I'm Jordan Rakei, and this is my beat from scratch. What I like to do first is to get like an original sort of natural feel. I like to go through and sort of sample old breaks. I think what I want to do first is get a natural sounding hi-hat. So I'm just going to click on this My Breaks collection and let's try and find a nice hi-hat vibe. So we've got a hi-hat here. Let's go for like a 95 tempo. Just going to find the hi-hat vibe. So here's some in here. And I imagine there's some in there. There's another one there. Okay, cool. So that's four hi-hats. And because you can see they're different tempo, I'll just quickly fade the events, join it, and then tempo stretch it to a perfect beat. And then if I loop this with a click, cool, I'm gonna mono the hi-hats. Okay. Let's get all the low end out of that for a bit more natural vibes. Brighten it up slightly. The thing I like about sampled hi-hats is it's got like character. Now let's find an open hi-hat. There's one there. And this is usually what I do to start like some beats or start an idea is like work through old samples. Okay, this just doesn't really matter. Don't have to be too deep with it. Just drag it a whole beat. Okay, we're gonna have to go like that. Alt, drag it. Always make sure to fade it. And let's turn it down, roll the lows off it. Okay. Okay, we're gonna loop this. Okay, cool. So now let's get some like kicks happening. So we've got sort of like a feel. I like that kick. So I'm a drag and drop sort of producer with my drum samples at least. I feel like visualizing where everything is coming, it's a lot easier for me to like really get a pocket of the drum. So let's just do a 5-bar loop. Ba-boom. So one and two and ba-boom. And I create like basically a ghost thing. If I go custom here, 16th notes. Trick I like to do is like, let's see. If that's a 16th, that's gonna be perfectly quantized. What I like to usually do is basically split the difference between the 16th and the 32nd, and that'll give you the triplet feel of like a kick, and then that could be the ghost kick vibe. Same sort of thing. There's the 16th there. We're just gonna drag it slightly after. And then this sort of pattern again. Okay, cool. Let's just get some side six, some snares happening. That's a bit vintage. And just for the sake of time, let's just loop it on the 2 and 4. Cool, I'm gonna record a shaker, get more natural element. Is that working? Nice. So what I like to do with shakers is I like to record one, then instantly mute it. I go very speed to get like a slightly different texture, and you can like pitch it right up. And when you record it at a different very speed, it'll transform the audio when you come back to its original tempo. Doesn't need to be too rigid. You can just sort of pick any loop here. I'll just choose, I don't know, this loop here. Now, if I go back to the original tempo, turn it back up. That's one shaker at the original tempo. So I'll go original shaker. Let's get this new shaker here, which will sound like this compared to. So obviously it's a different pitch, but it's a different feel as well because I played it at a different very speed tempo. I'm gonna loop it. pan them left and right, get the groove happening. Here we go. And with shake is what I like to do in Logic. There's a really cool feature. There's a delay function up here. I basically offset it like up to 30 to 40 to get it behind the beat. Cool, let's keep building it. Claps. Okay, here we go. And basically I just delete all the ones that are too loud with too much of a transient. And create four clap tracks. So you can see here, I'm just dragging them in. Let's do, for the sake of it, let's do five for vibes. This one's slightly too delayed. We're gonna offset pan them. Some can be extreme, some can be central. And then for cleanliness, let's join all of it as a one bar loop. Send this to a clap bus. And we're gonna call these clap bus. Straight away before I even hear it, I don't even know what it sounds like yet. I'm gonna compress it to get a bit more smack. And I use the distressor from UAD. Now I'll send those claps to a spring verb. And I just use Logic Spring Reverb. Sometimes I use the spring from my RE 201 Space Echo just to the left of me, but I think this spring reverb on Logic is actually really good. It's underrated little plugin, free plugin. So I'm going to go back to this same sample that we got the open hi-hat and just find like maybe about three different eighth note hi-hats. There's one there, doesn't need to be perfect cut. Always fade your samples. Let's get a couple more percussive elements. Let's go like cowbell. We're gonna join that here. Send that to the same spring reverb, which I think was that one. But let's get one more, maybe something on the four, like a tambourine hit. Sweet. So before I do anything, I'm just going to clean everything up by pressing Control L J, turning them all into like functional sort of audio events, but they're all the same length. And then that's the basis of the drum. So I'm gonna drag these all up to the top, and now let's head on over to the synths to build around this. So what I wanna do now is sort of do a pedal note, which is like where one note stays and I wanna build a chord sequence around it. So I want to do that on the Juno and like find a vibe that I like. Let's see where it takes us. So I'm going to play the drums and then record this. Cool. Happy with the last bar of that. Let's just get that looping. And then I'm just going to play along, find chords that work with it. Actually, what I'll do is I'll get a pedal from this space echo as well and just let that be trinkling. I'm going to loop, record the rows and get some chords happening. What I might do is actually play some chords and then chop them up. I'll keep that for later because maybe we'll use the OB6 instead. But same thing with the OB6. I'll try and come up with a sequence now. Thank you. Turn that into a loop. I'll play over that. What I'd like to do is actually create like a really weird Rhodes texture in this last chord. Unpack all of those two new tracks, and that way basically I just was able to record five different things. I don't know what I did. I'm just going to pan some there, reverse two of them. Let's see if they get some more layers in. Yeah, I like the idea of it being again out of time. I'm into that sort of thing, so I'm just going to do this, record it, see what happens. Okay, and then I think I need to get a real Rhodes take, maybe just playing the chords. Let's get one more thing, doubling this OB6 thing, just to give it a bit more clarity. Yeah, cool, I think. Yeah, so I think that's it synth-wise. Now what I want to do is like create two things with my vocals. I want to try and get like a vocal sample thing happening and also get like a pad thing happening. So let's see how we go. I usually sing like different harmonies. I chop it up and try and make a pad out of it. And then I'll also do a take of singing to various speed, but here we go. So what I just did there was like sing, I don't know, four or five different notes. I'm going to chop them in any order. It doesn't need to be that deep. You can chop them anywhere because they're going to be heavily faded anyway. So just take areas of that, chop it. Don't worry too much. Create the amount of tracks that you have. So I just did five different notes there. Going to drag them all here. Just going to loop it. Send all of these to a bus again. And why I like doing that is because you can save, obviously, CPU by just processing all of those with one channel rather than obviously doing each effect to each channel. So I'm going to roll off all the lows because I just want these to be a pad, and the more lows there are, the more cloggy you'll get with like my Rhodes sound. So what I'll do is actually I'll just solo the Rhodes part, which was here. A couple I might reverse again for no reason, and then that one I might like time stretch out like that long just to get a bit more textural. And then on that channel I put this, I don't know, something like a repeater, which is like a cool like old school digital delay. Obviously, you got to chuck a reverb on that for lushness. Disguise the fades as well. Reverb's good for like, when you're doing pad stuff like this, it's good. Obviously, roll off the lows again. We don't need that. So this is without my vocal. With my vocal. But those sort of things, like textures like that, I think add a lot. And what I might do to that as well is, there's a really amazing tremolo by UAD called Cyclosonic Panner. Sounds like a Terminator, basically. And I just chuck it on anything. After finally all that processing, I'll just do it with the Logic one, but I would sidechain that with the kick. I don't want to do too much because sometimes it just sounds a bit too like overdone, that sidechain thing. And that's just getting a bit more space in the mix, really. Now what I'll do is I'll do another vocal take. I'm gonna very speed it back up plus 14, so it's gonna sound like this. And I'm gonna sing into it. When you sing at a very speed above the original tempo, you'll see what happens. But basically it makes me sound like a lot more warm. I'm gonna sing random words and then try and find a cool phrase, put into a MIDI keyboard, and then let's go for it. Say, finally I don't play. You say it's nobody's got me again. Say, look what you got. I don't want to even listen to it yet because like that sort of makes you think about it too much. So I'm going to chop each one at the start of the waveform. Doesn't have to be perfect again. Chop each one. Basically we're creating individual events for each of the vocal phrases that I sang. I press Control E. This is for Logic users. Apologies to everyone else. And it's going to go into like a sampler. Again, before I hear it, I want to roll off the lows if you haven't noticed the trend yet, because this isn't that important, this sort of thing. Maybe even make me roll off the highs so it's a bit more lo-fi. Let's just chuck a gentle reverb on it. Usually I'll do this on a bus. And then to see what works, I'm just gonna go through my MIDI keyboard and see what happens. Okay, cool. So I like that one. I'm just going to quantize it, chop it. So I want to like basically get that note to double the length. So I'll create another one, put it there, maybe reverse it, time stretch it. So it's like really lengthening over that section, fading it, chopping it right on the one there. That should actually be at the end there. That's cool with me. So let's just join that and then just do a quick arrangement of this vibe. So what I would probably do is not start with the drums and start with the pedal note, which I think was this, with the Rhodes. Those trickles can go into the drum drop. Maybe these little melodic lines could come in on the, maybe after this sort of intro verse, we've got pedal note there. Bass line could obviously come on the drums. My pads could be swelling in 2 bar 9, And then my vocal little thing that I just did could come in like bar 17. Yeah, so it can start minimal, get like a bit of a vibe. No lead lines, Rhodes, drums. With this sort of thing, the way I think about like songwriting is, I try and like we've just seen now, I try and get as many things as possible all happening in like a 16 bar loop. And then all arranging is taking elements out rather than having that and then putting more elements in, I think. So yeah, let's just have a listen. That is basically how I make a track.